Alright lads, welcome back to another video, and this one is going to be about three separate topics. You'll have seen by the thumbnail, the title, etc, etc already, what those three are, but for just clarity, I'll go over them again. VAR, Celtic picking up the 3 points as Rangers drop points, and Hearts finally appointing a new manager. I've chosen these three topics because they're probably the most poignant after the sort of midweek period of Scottish football this week, and I'm trying to do a video every day of December, and I thought I maybe can't make a full video out of just one of those topics, so shove them all together in the one video and see where that takes us. So first up, let's get on to the first topic of VAR. Scotland to use VAR for first time in Euro 2020 playoff against Israel. The controversial technology has been given the green light for all playoff games by UEFA chiefs. Now, this one obviously brings its own controversy, as the headline of the Daily Record said there. That was where I got this kind of breaking news from. And obviously, with it being a UEFA competition, we now have no choice but to go by their ruling. And they want to bring in VAR for these playoff games, the ones that are happening in March, for the Euro 2020 positions that we'll end up hopefully being a part of. So the first game we will see VAR used in Scottish football will be at Hampden Park in March when we play Israel. And it's going to be a controversial one, there's no doubt about that. It's going to cause a scene, I think. It's probably going to cause a lot more problems than it will be in a positive light, because it just has that feel about it. Fans are not really behind it at all, and you only need to look south of the border to find that out, because obviously it's been trailed massively in the English Premier League this season so far, and it's also been involved in the Champions League as well. And as I said, it's just had a lot of issues surrounding it. Us in Scottish football, we can't yet have it in place in Scottish football because of the cost that it involves. Me personally, don't want to see it in Scottish football. I don't want to see it come into Scottish football. I don't necessarily have that much of an issue with VAR itself, but the controversy that it brings and the type of conversations you'd have to have continuously throughout a season about it, it's just not worth the hassle in my opinion. At the end of the day, football is what it is, and the controversy that comes around the referees getting the wrong decisions and human error and stuff like that, that's enough controversy for me. Having VAR on top of that, which also shows the same sort of refereeing mistakes, and then you could go to VAR and it could still be the same mistake made because they might not give a penalty when it should be. I just think it's too much controversy to have in the one time, and I don't want to see it come to Scottish football. I don't think it will, because I think the cost will always be a problem, and I don't think VAR will ever be that popular a thing that people will be calling for it to come into the game. I think goal line technology would be fantastic, really, because it always offers a 100% fact element to it. It's, if the ball goes over the line, it's over the line, and the referee gets the wee buzzer on his watch or whatever it is, and it tells him if it goes over the line. Whereas VAR, it's still very opinionated. It's still very opinion-based as to whether what fouls are what fouls. Obviously, they have officials sitting in with the VAR and making the decisions, really. So, it's always very opinionated, and it would just add so much controversy to the game. And I just simply don't want to see it involved in Scottish football. So, I hope that's the case, and I hope that we can keep loving football in its real form rather than having to rely on other elements like VAR to enhance the game as the bigwigs of football would like it to be. So the next thing I'm going to speak about is Rangers dropping points last night as Celtic picked up a very late win, and these were both very controversial games in terms of what actually happened in terms of the scoreline at different points in the game. Obviously, Rangers going 2-0 up against Aberdeen away at Pittodrie. Ryan Jacks going against his former team. And overall, it looking like Rangers would just go on and win this game and pick up another 3 points, another important 3 points considering where they were playing obviously with it being at Aberdeen. Aberdeen always tend to give Rangers a decent enough game at Pittodrie. They never really seem to do the same against Celtic for whatever reason. On the flip side, Celtic were playing Hamilton Academical at home. And on paper, you'd look at that game and think, easy one for Celtic, you'd say maybe 3 or 4-0. Perhaps give Hamilton a consolation goal at some point in the game, but you'd expect Celtic to win by a good few goal margin. Well, that certainly wasn't the case, because it was 1-0 going into what, the last couple of minutes of the game, and then Hamilton scored in the 90th minute, and that obviously made it 1-1. And then somehow Scott Brown got the winning goal for Celtic and really cemented his place as that captain, leader, legend for Celtic in the last decade or so. He just keeps proving why he's such a vital part of Celtic Football Club, both on and off the park. A few seasons ago, you may have been saying that Scott Brown was coming to the end because of the players that were coming through at Celtic. You maybe thought, well, is it his time as a key role in the Celtic midfield? And here he is, going into 2020, still scoring last minute winners to perhaps end up winning Celtic another league title, because if they win the league title now by 2 points, say, then Scott Brown will have contributed to winning Celtic the title, basically, because as Rangers dropped points, as I said, they only picked up the one and Celtic picked up three. So they're now 2 points ahead of Rangers. The gap was already down to goal difference and Celtic had the better end of that, so they're a further goal ahead in that. Rangers yet again dropped points at a vital time, and it's happened a lot of times in the past few seasons where Rangers have just slipped up at the wrong moment. Celtic have done it so far this season, but they've managed to claw that back by, I think since they lost against Livingston, they've won every single game, and that's the type of mentality that that squad just has had over the last 3 seasons at least, especially under Brendan Rodgers, and now they're really starting to show it under Neil Lennon in the last, 12 games. And Rangers, they'd only lost one game so far this season, and that was obviously against Celtic. They drew against Hearts, and now they've drawn against Aberdeen. So you would say the two teams they've drawn against should be the two teams that you could possibly expect it to be, albeit Hearts aren't the team they once were. But Rangers getting that result, they will not be happy with that. That is not the result that they would have wanted last night, especially after being 2-0 up. They did have a penalty claim at one point, and it should have been a penalty, I think, but they didn't get it, and they ended up drawing the game 2-2, and Celtic went on to win, as I said. So it was a very important night in the Scottish Premiership, and one that could end up having a very massive say come the end of the season. And now the final thing I'm going to talk about in this video is Hearts hoping to eventually appoint Daniel Stendel, the former Barnsley manager, as their new manager. Obviously, Hearts have been without a manager since sacking Craig Levein. Craig Levein's sort of still been kicking about Hearts because he's still got a bit of his contract to go, so he's still in and around the club, and Hearts are now eventually getting to the final stages of appointing Daniel Stendel. Apparently Barnsley have had a lot to do with this sort of hold up in appointing him, because they want compensation for him. And Budge herself has said this has been a tortuous process for Hearts to appoint a new manager. So perhaps it's going to have taken longer than they would have hoped to get a new manager in. But it looks like they're going to get their man. Daniel Stendel seems like a solid enough appointment for Hearts. And with the squad that they've got, albeit they're not performing to the standard they should be. Obviously, last night's 1-1 draw against Livingston would have shown that. But that squad on paper, for me, should be doing far better than it is. It shouldn't be down the very bottom reaches of the league. Perhaps they'll finish bottom six this season, because I just don't think they're good enough to be top six. But they should be in the upper parts of that bottom six part of the table, definitely. Considering it's not that different a squad for last season that did indeed finish in the top six. So I don't know how much of an impact Daniel Stendel will end up having at Hearts, but I think eventually over time, once he gets his own stamp on the team, and obviously having to work with the players at hand that's already in the squad at Hearts, I think he will eventually turn it round if he is indeed appointed, which it looks like, as I said, it's in the final stages of. So it looks like a good appointment for Hearts in my opinion, and one that will eventually start keeping them back up the league. Bye, that's it for this video guys, cheers for watching. If you did enjoy it, please give it a like, comment down below your thoughts on all the things I've talked about, VAR, Rangers and Celtic, and Hearts appointing a new manager. Subscribe for more of this type of content, and until the next video, I'll see you then. Cheers, guys.